For some people, being in contact with recruiters can seem intimidating. However, I assure you that recruiters want the best for both candidates and the company. Good recruiters would also want you to have the best possible experience through the recruitment process. But even though they would like the best for you, there are certain things which are confidential or simply can't be shared with you. I'm Marat from Emotion, myemotion.com, career and recruitment agency. Look me up on LinkedIn. Please subscribe to my channel below and hit the little bell so you won't miss out on the latest career and personal growth content. Also, thumb up the video if you feel it was useful. Here come 5 things that recruiters won't tell you, but what I think you should know. Number 1, you didn't stand a chance after a bad first impression. First impressions are still very meaningful. There are some recruiters which will put first impressions aside, but unreturned calls, bad manners, sloppy interview will definitely hurt your chances for the next round. If you made a negative first impression, you must really dazzle to make up for it. For many positions, interviewers care more about the likability of a candidate rather than the overall qualification for the job. The person who is interviewing you might be your future manager, and it's completely normal that they wouldn't want to hire someone they don't like or someone they are not comfortable working with. Number 2, you could have gotten a higher salary. Salary negotiations are a bit tug of war. Both job seekers and recruiters try to get the most suitable deal. No company would ever admit that they would actually pay more. There is often a salary range that recruiters have for each role, and a lot of times the initial salary offer can be negotiated to a higher amount. Keep in mind that the recruiter wants to make the placement. This means they will support you in getting what you want, if that's what it takes to fill the position. Your references were bad. If a recruiter or hiring manager have doubts about you, they won't let you know if your unflattering references confirm their doubts. Bad references can ruin your candidacy as much as the good ones can make it stronger. If you give out references, it should be one of those who will say positive things about you. Even if you choose not to give out anyone at your current job as a reference, backdoor references is now a sneaky way for hiring managers and recruiters to gather more information about you. It means they will reach out to mutual connections to get their honest opinion of you. So aside from your official references, backdoor references can be especially common when you are looking for a job in different sectors, like tech, for example. Number 4, your social media ruined your chances. What you've heard is true. Almost 80% of recruiters or hiring managers use social media to check out their applicants' social media presence. Which is why your social media has to reflect the image of the brand you are projecting. It should be complementing your resume. In a way, speak how truthful everything about you is. Also, potential employers don't usually want to see strong political views or posts or any information that could be considered offensive to anyone. Number 5, your appearance matters. Unfortunately, don't judge a book by its cover do not apply to most of job interviews. The candidate's appearance should be completely irrelevant, but it can charm or scare the hiring manager. Of course, the company is hiring you for your skills and capabilities, but the way you are dressed and groomed is just as important as well. Even if you are interviewing for a casual work environment, the general rule is to come well-groomed for any interview. Let me know what has been your experience in dealing with recruiters in the comment section below. And if you found this video useful, then please give it a thumb up and share it with whoever you think it might be helpful to. Don't forget to subscribe, and see you in my next video coming up.